Hyacinth. It is one of those flowers that tells us that spring is right around the corner. Hi, this is Margaret Byrd and welcome to Color Quest. I was super excited to find hyacinth in my local shop recently, and so I brought a few bouquets home. Not only do they smell incredible, they also add such a beautiful color to any bouquet that you have in the springtime. As you can see here, these are definitely faded, and it's now time to see what this beautiful blue spring flower might provide us in the way of natural color. I understand that if you treat hyacinth with some gentle love, that it may share some of this glorious blue in the dye pot. We're not going to be using heat this time, though. We will try a cold extraction. And the reason is because blue, I have found, tends to be quite sensitive to heat. And what I don't want to do is lose the blue if it is something that I can actually keep for natural color. So as you know, blue is quite rare in nature. So I'm excited to see if this delicate flower is willing to share some of its beautiful blue in my dye practice. Join me now as we look to see if hyacinth wants to share blue with us. Thank you. So, did you see a shift in color from when I first pulled it out, then after it dried? I personally think that maybe oxygen had some kind of a play in shifting it from that more vibrant pinkish violet to a very subtle blue. I suppose on the rainbow spectrum, it may fall into the violet spectrum, so it's sharing its blue with a little bit of help from the surroundings. I'm really glad that I tried it with a cold process, and something you may not be able to see from the video is that the consistency was viscous. I don't know why that is, but it was a very different dye than I expected, but also extremely giving in its color. Having put it into the water to soak just overnight in the first part, and then moving it and adding additional water, you saw the difference between how much blue came out after just a quick and simple soak overnight. The textile samples stayed in the dye for maybe 3 days. I played around with putting them in the sun and on my windowsill, and just to give it more time for the color to adhere to the textile. So, I'm pretty happy with it. It's a fun new color. Obviously, it doesn't last for very long because hyacinth is pretty short-lived, but it's a fun way to take a spring bulb and just enjoy the color in a slightly different manner. So, next time on Color Quest, we'll be going back to Aruba to finish a few more videos on some other plants that I collected while I was there. And if you enjoy using flowers as a potential dye matter, you should check out the playlist that I have called Flower Power and see additional ways in which you can use flowers and faded bouquets to create color in your dye pot. If you like what you see, give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Spread the word to other people who are interested in learning about natural color. So, thanks so much again. Look forward to seeing you over in Aruba, and have a great week. See you next Friday. So hard today. It's the Easter eggs. They're causing me all the grief. Okay.